survivors of COVID-19. We just want to say, through it all, 2020 has been a difficult year, but we still have to give God thanks. So we just want you to sit back and listen in. We are playing some songs as we let more people come in, and we will just start our program shortly. Thank you. My name is Alfred Osborne. I'm the board member of the Rosedale Civic Association and your master's ceremonies for this evening. Thank you.
Thank you.
Deep in the stillness, I can hear you speak. You're still an inspiration. Can it be that you are mine forever, love, and you are watching to where you are beyond distant star. I wish you well tonight to see you smile. If only for a while to know
Again, I'd like to get started. Again, my name is Alfred Osborne. I'm a board member of the Rosedale Civic Association. Just ask that you will mute your phones at this time, your computers, so that we don't have a feedback. Just want to say welcome you to this time that we've set aside to honor those who have transitioned, remember the families who are grieving, celebrate those who are survivors of COVID-19. Now, none of us expected to be here, but God knows best, and we're here to let you know that those who have transitioned will never be forgotten. And those who are surviving, we will always keep you in our prayers. We are at a juncture where we have, so far to date, in the U.S., over 296,000 deaths that have occurred. And we just want to come and pause and take some time out. Please stay muted, please, out of our busy schedule. So it's now 6:11. I'd like to get started. 6:12. I'd like to get started now at this time and get the program and started. All right. So at this time, I would like to ask our opening prayer by the Reverend Steve Foster. The very Reverend Steve Foster, who's the rector of St. Peter's Episcopal Church. He will come in and invoke the Holy Spirit and start with prayer. We need God right at the center of everything that we do, and we just want to welcome him as he come on. Is the very Reverend Stephen Foster, are you on the line, Steve Foster?
Good evening, friends. It's a joy to be with you as the Rosedale Civic Association. Prayers for all who are at this time on the line and those who are awaiting to be allowed in. I invite you just to plant your feet in the presence of the Lord as we bring ourselves together in this time of prayer and reflection. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks for this new day of service and pleasing you. We come offering ourselves, all that we are, all that would ever be, seeking your grace, protection, and guidance. As we gather, we pray your blessing on the Rosedale Civic Association, its work to foster unity among Rosedale residents. We lift up those who are called to positions of leadership and oversight. We pray that they may not lead for selfish gain, but for the interests and benefit of the organization. In this season of COVID-19 pandemic, where there's great loss and tumult, make us uniquely aware and attuned to each other's need. Lord, we pray for those who have been infected or affected, or those who've lost their lives. Gracious God, give skill, sympathy, and resilience to all who are caring for the sick, wisdom to those who are searching for a cure. Strengthen them with your spirit especially those who from our community are working feverishly and tirelessly, giving of themselves as their care for others and restoring them to health. Lord, you call us to be people of fear, not people of fear, but of courage, people of hope, but people of faith. We are not people who protect our own safety. We are people who are called to protect the safety of our neighbors. We are not people of greed. We are people of generosity. We are your people, God, giving and loving wherever we are, whatever it costs, for as long as it takes. You have called us to be this community. Lord, we pray that this civic association may always work towards one accord. All this we pray in your holy and precious name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, the very Reverend Steve Foster, from director at St. Peter's Episcopal Church right here in Rosedale. We thank you for that opening prayer and invocation and invoking the Holy Spirit in what we're about to do. And I just wanted to say at this time, if we can have the praise dance by Thalia Williams from the class of 2021, senior at Cristo Rey Brooklyn High School. We have...
Soul to
Beautiful, beautiful. Donnie McClurkin and Yolanda Adams, the prayer. We could continue with any more sounds that we have. We'd like to acknowledge any of our, any of our elective officials that are with us. We want to thank you for, coming on here and being part of this experience. We just are thankful to have you on. By any chance I may not call your name, just want to let you know that we are happy that you're here and that you're listening in to our celebration of love and honor and really respectfully honoring those who have gone and passed on to this tragic illness. At this time, if there's anyone who has a song, let's have the praise dance right now. We're gonna have the praise dance by Thalia Williams, and then we're gonna have our guest remarks by our Donovan Richards. Thank you.
Actually, our borough president is on, and
he
just hopped off a meeting to come be with us, so we can go ahead and introduce him.
Okay, sure. Our borough president is on. We want to welcome our newly elected bar president, Queens Bar president, our very own Donovan Richards, who was our councilman for the 31st Council Matic District. He's on now at Queens Bar president. We want to hear from you during this time of where we are grieving, and we are grieving those who've lost their loved ones, but come and give us a lift and help us still celebrate those who still survive and those who've transitioned on. You have the floor, you have the mic, our bar president, Queens Bar president, Donovan Richards.
Thank you, Al, and thank you, MLN, and to everybody on, thank you so much. I know I'm juggling a lot tonight, but this was so important to attend, and I think about, over the course of the last few months, how all of our lives have drastically changed. I mean, whether you lost someone or not, everybody's been impacted by this pandemic one way or another. And I'm often reminded of good friends like Jules Taylor, so many other folks that I knew who transitioned on to the pearly gates, as we know. There's no easy words, when you come to events like this. There's nothing that I can say that will bring back those individuals. But one thing that I do know we all can do is carry on their legacies. Although they're not here physically, they're here in spirit. And we have to keep that fighting spirit going on in Rosedale and in Southeast Queens. This pandemic has certainly shed a light on so many things that we've known historically that have impacted our communities around healthcare, around food insecurity, around housing. And, I've spent the last few days, traveling around the borough, in particular visiting hospitals just to get a good sense of where we're at. And for every institution I go to, we hear that there are so many needs and that we need quality healthcare. But we give and pay homage to those frontline workers who, even through their own pain, some who we've lost. I lost a good friend who worked at Elmhurst Hospital, Priscilla, who was a big supporter of my campaign, but I knew her going back from my first time running for the city council. And she was someone who was out there every day. And, she, unfortunately lost her life, you know, servicing others in Elmhurst Hospital. And what was crazy about being there, which felt so surreal on Thursday, was, you know, I have a good friend who goes to my church who works at Elmhurst as well. And she's like, I want to show you Jackie's last text to me. And one of her last texts, the last two texts were, I'm out here campaigning for Donovan Richards, trying to get the vote out. And then the next text, you know, she never answered. So this hits hard, you know, hits home. This pandemic has impacted each and every one of us. But we got to carry on, and we got to make sure that, you know, the work that so many of those who've transitioned on continues, right? And that means doing what we do each and every day, making sure that our institutions are better, looking out for our neighbors. You know, I'm happy to see Rosedale, even through this crisis, still holding their Christmas event, right? Marcia and others and all of you are still holding the toy drive, which is so important because there's such an immense need out there when you look at the food pantry lines that have quadrupled. And this is not just Southeast Queens. I mean, it's literally the entire borough. So we have to continue to look out for one another. And that's what gives me comfort during these times, knowing we're moving into 2021, which we hope will be a better year for each and every one of us. Even as this vaccine comes online, you know, one of the things I've spent the last few days doing, and now I get to go into the governor's war room every day. And we've been very clear that, you know, the communities impacted, the communities hit hardest are the ones who should be prioritized through this struggle, whether it's the vaccine. And I know that, you know, for our communities, Black and Brown communities, we have, you know, there's a history with vaccines and there's a lack of trust. But, you know, I've said that I'm going to be one of the first, that I'll be on the front lines, whatever is needed to make sure that we can prioritize and get this vaccine into people's, into our communities. I'm going to be on the front lines pushing for that. So just getting back to, I just wanted to throw those things out there quickly, but just getting back to all of those we've lost. You know, on December 17th, I'm proud to announce, I believe that we will have a street renaming voted out. Even though I've transitioned on from the city council, you know, before I left, I called the speaker's chief of staff. I was like, I got some street renamings that have to get done. And Jules Taylor is at the top of that list. So it has to get done, although there'll be a vacancy over the course of the next, next month or two. So I'm happy to say that that's going to happen. And that's the way we honor, you know, we have to honor those who've done the work. You know, and you know, we often pass by street signs of people we don't know. And one of the greatest honors is to be able to rename a street in honor of someone who gave so much to our community. You know, I have the honor, like many of you, I see some of you out in Brookfield Park often. Well, at least when I was able to go out there and walk in the mornings, now that has drastically changed. But, you know, I'm reminded when I walk past, you know, the tennis courts of how much Jules harassed us to get that done. And I remember getting the lights done and then, you know, the lights not being filtered in the right direction at one point. And him like a week later saying, we got to fix this. But to all of you who've lost a loved one during this time. And I know it doesn't get easier during the holidays. And this, you know, this is one of the hardest, you know, difficult things to do, right? Because it's easy for me to get up and give a scripted speech, and I'm not giving a scripted speech. It's easy for me to say things because I have not necessarily lost a family member during this period, you know, although I lost friends. You know, we got to hold on, and we just got to be there for each other. And I think now requires us to be here for each other more than any other time, because, you know, the holidays feel much different. You know, you think about how we're not able to necessarily, I know this past Thanksgiving, I wasn't necessarily able to go to my mom's house, and I know she missed us, but we had to practice social distance. We had to practice what we preach, and it's been difficult for each and every one of us. You know, but if you're on this line and you're feeling alone, you know, you should not hesitate to pick up the phone and call us. You know, I know, you know, we should be checking up on our neighbors. We know people who've lost individuals. We need to make sure that we are being good neighbors for those of us on this line, and spreading that love, right? Because a lot of people are hurting this holiday season. There are empty chairs at tables. And this should never have happened, let's be clear. You know, we had an administration that was inept, that downplayed this, and we lost people because you had, you know, as they say, when the elephants fight, the ants get trampled on. We all got trampled on through this process. Mm-hmm. And I even look at the impact just on my son, right? You know, who's finally, you know, doing blended learning, but he's home, you know, and he's five now and he's trying to manage learning on a computer. He gets frustrated sometimes. I get impatient, you know, but he's, you know, now back in school. You think of, you know, small businesses who have to close on Monday, just the impact on all of our mental health, right? And I think that's something we have to speak about as a community. You know, we all are hurting. We all need some assistance, some help, somebody to talk to. You know, and we have to be real about that. But as we move into the holidays, like I said, I love each and every one of you. You know, we all, like I said, are going to have to band together moving into 2021. I am optimistic about where we're going to head and where we're going to go. But Rosedale is a family, you know, and that's one thing I appreciate. I always feel at home and at ease, you know, even as I travel around a borough and I get to learn new people. You know, today I was out in Laurelton at a tree lighting, and that's what's special about this community, right? We are family, even through disagreement, you know, at times, you know, but one thing we can do is always be able to count on each other, and be able to talk to one another and be able to encourage one another. And that's what we're going to have to continue to do. So I'm not here necessarily to spread a lecture or anything, because I think Rosedale has always had the blueprint of where we need to go and what a community truly looks like. I'll end in just saying, you know, there are a lot of folks hurting, and I'm trying to figure this thing out, you know, as we've transitioned into this office. You know, we lost some folks to a fire, you know, folks burnt out, had a big fire last night or two nights ago in Richmond Hill. So we all got to band together. And if you can give, that's the best way to remember those we've lost, right? Anything you can do. If you don't got the money, then figure out some volunteer time, right? And I think that's the way, honestly, we can honor those that we've lost this this season. So I want you, each and every one of you, to know that I love you. You know how I feel about you, Emmeline. You know, and each and every one of you who've been through this, and we've been through hell and high water together. You know, even in politics, it's a roller coaster, you know, even, you know, but one of the things I always love is I always had encouragement. We always encourage each other here, and we're going to have to continue to do that through this time as well. So with that being said, thank you. Stay encouraged. Stay strong. We all got to pray for each other. We got to pray harder. you know, coming into this season and into this next year, let's be there for each other. That if there's anything I can say today, any, you know, as I end these remarks, we have to be there for one another. We should all have each other's numbers. Although I'm the bar president, I'm not too big or too busy to ever pick up the phone. You know, but what I would say is we should all, every person on this call should at least pick up the phone and call one person outside of your family this holiday season just to check in on them, especially those who we know lost a loved one through this pandemic. I think it's critical that we do that. And next year, we're going to all regroup. Like I said, I can't wait for next year to be back at the Veterans Hall, you know, with Emmeline and everybody trying to pack me a plate. I can't wait for a lot of ribbon cuts. There's going to be a lot more joy next year. And so I want you all to really keep that in mind, even through your darkest times. Remember, there's a light tunnel ahead, and we're all going to get through this together. So with that being said, thank you. Thank you for having me this evening. It's an honor and a privilege. It's not about Donovan Richards, but it's an honor and privilege to be from this community and to be able to serve the wider Queens. Even as I look at the title on this screen, I would not be here if it were not for you. And I want you to know that we are forever in debt to this community and to Rosedale Civic Association. It's beyond politics. You all have exuberated excellence and love. And I want you to all know that I love each and every one of you. So happy holidays, happy Kwanzaa. Let's stick together. Let's stay safe. Let's look out for one another, mask up, social distance, and let's be there for one another. With that being said, thank you for having me. God bless each and every one of you. Have a great new year, and I'll see you out there.
Borough President.
Thank you. Thank you.
Borough President Donovan Richards, the Taylor family are ever so grateful just for everything that you do for not only us, but for our entire community. Just wanted to say that. And I just want to let everybody know that Borough President Richards is going to jump off because he was in another meeting and jumped on. So if you see him disappear, it's not because he doesn't want to be here for the whole thing, but it's because he has to go back where he was, but he paused because this was important. He made a commitment to the civic to be here, and he was here, and we appreciate that. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Emily. Thank you. God bless each and every one of you. Good to see you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Queensborough President. Yes, one of our own representing now the entire the entire Borough of Queens.
2.4 million people.
Yes. 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 You have our prayers.
Thank you.
That's for sure. You have our prayers and all the success. At this time, we're going to continue with a praise dance by Thalia Williams. She's the graduate from the class of 2021 from Crystal Ray Brooklyn High School. Let's give her a shout out to Thalia Williams.
Oh, no. What happened? Come on, video. All right, I'm gonna try to fix the video because it was playing just fine before, but this is technology for you.
Seriously, and they don't play.
Can everybody mute their phones, please.
Everybody mute your
everybody
phones.
Mute your phones.
Yeah, while our president gets that in, I just like to acknowledge that our Queens. Our Assemblywoman Alicia Hyman is on the line and she's here with us. Alicia Hyman, our Assemblywoman and in Queens, and we want to thank her for taking the time, coming on out and listening and being part of this very important honor where we're honoring those who have transitioned and those families. Okay, here we go. Here we go now, the praise dance. Thalia Williams, class of 2021.
And I will forever feel your strength when I need it more. You're gone now, gone but not forgotten. I can't say yes to your faith, but I know you
Isn't that beautiful? That's one of the students at my high school. And we are so proud of her. All right, Mr. Osborne, you have the mic back. You have to unmute. Al, unmute yourself. While we get our MC back, I want to thank everybody who's on the line with us. Oh, here we are.
Yes, there he yes. goes. I'm unmuted. Thank you so much. There oh, goes technology.
That's okay.
Thank you at this time.
We're still grateful for it.
Yes, we're grateful. At this time, we're going to have one of our members of the Rosedale Civic Association, Derek DeFloremonte. We call him Derek DeFlo. He will speak on health and safety. Don't let our guard down. You have the floor, Derek DeFlo. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much. Good evening, everyone. My name is Derek DeFloremont, also known as Derek DeFlo. I also want to say thank you to the borough president for being on, for pushing that message, honestly, because right now we are facing very challenging times when it comes to the COVID crisis. I'll give you a little bit of background about myself. I'm not going to stay on too long, but I am in the Army. And I also work in the medical section where I was actually one of the very first people to respond to the COVID response when the governor called a state of emergency. I got called up to Westchester County, and lately I've been working down in the city area. I just want to touch on a few things related to COVID-19 and let you guys know what's going on out there. The first thing I want to touch on this slide right now is the test, trace, and take care of yourselves. This is a New York City initiative that they're pushing right now. So the biggest thing that we're trying to do right now is make sure that people get tested. The biggest thing about getting tested is knowing if you have the virus. A lot of people think that, you know, they're not feeling fever. They don't have a fever. They're not feeling any nauseousness, any headache, any sickness, that they don't have to get checked out or they might not have the virus. But I just want to let you guys know that even if you're not feeling the symptoms, please still get checked out. Also, please be mindful of the people that you're around. So now this jumps into the trace aspect of everything. Know the people that you are around. The people that you are around are very crucial. I can tell you firsthand experience, I've worked with many people that have been tested positive for coronavirus. And myself, I've got tested about, multiple times. I've gotten the nose stick, I've gotten the blood draw, and thank God I've been having tested positive, but I'm taking the very serious precautions to make sure that my family and myself are not gonna be affected with this. Also, making sure that you take care of yourself. That goes to what I just now said. Making sure that you're using the proper precautions when it comes to face masks, when it comes to proper hygiene, when it comes to making sure that you're 6 feet away from each other. Let's make sure that we're following social distancing. If you go to the next slide, that goes to my prevention. So in terms of prevention, the biggest thing that I want people to take away from this, I know it's a little hard to see right now, but just make sure if you do not have to leave the house, please, I beg, please stay in the house and make sure that you when if you do have to go out, make sure that you take the proper precautions when you do go out. Make sure that you are wearing a mask, wear a surgical mask. If you do have the N95 mask, it is a great mask to wear, but please leave those for the healthcare providers that are working in the field every single day. The surgical mask that you see a lot of people wearing right now.
What's up?
Sorry.
Please.
So you were pulling the
mask. Please mute your lines.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, yeah, sorry. Yeah, so the surgical mask that you see a lot of people are wearing right now, please wear those. And if you do have the N95 mask, please save those for your healthcare workers, because those are very, very hard to come across. The surgical masks are very effective. It actually does protect other people from getting the virus, and it does protect you as well. But now when it comes to surgical masks, just please make sure that you're switching it out every day. We do have available resources if you do to get those masks. If you do need access to those masks, please private message me in this Zoom call, and I can actually direct you to the nearest area where you can get those masks. Also, in terms of prevention, please make sure that you stay 6 feet away from individuals when you're talking to them. So right now, the latest CDC guidance is that if you're within about less than 6 feet and also speaking to someone for about 15 minutes, it's recommended that you get tested. You want to make sure that you're not carrying on to someone else. That jumps back into the test, trace, and take care of yourself. Also, please be mindful of using proper hygiene, washing your hands, using the proper techniques when you have to cough or sneeze, using within the guard of your elbow. Also, making sure that you are not jumping in areas where other people are sick. So I understand that a lot of us are living in houses with multiple family members, right? But please, if you do know someone that is sick at the moment, or someone who is actually tested positive for COVID-19, please don't go into that area. You know, and if you do go into that area, make sure you're taking the proper precautions. Let's go on to the next slide again, please. Next slide. So now, one of my biggest things that I do in the military is I'm a medic and I'm also a mental health specialist. I want to kind of stick on this for about 2 seconds, because a lot of people are going through a lot of stress when it comes to COVID-19, because we are in the house and we're also dealing with a situation where we're not able to do the things that we're used to. I want people to understand that this is not something that's normal. This is not something that we're used to. This is not something that is the regular. This is something that we need to express ourselves about. You're gonna have physical and emotional symptoms when it comes to dealing with the COVID-19, mental stressors on your body. If you are feeling as if you're going a little crazy, you're feeling as if you need to talk to somebody, please don't hesitate. Talk to your friends, talk to your family members, talk to a licensed medical practitioner. Let people know how you are feeling, and we can get you the guidance to do what you have to do to make you feel a little better. If possible, please take walks and also walk around the block, take a bicycle ride around the park, and also pick up the phone. The biggest thing we can do right now is pick up the phone and talk to our loved ones and let them know exactly how we're feeling. If we go to our next slide, I'll also show you things that we can do to coping with stress during the COVID-19, right? So listen, sometimes playing the video game, you know, it's something that you're not used to. Do something that you're not used to. If you're doing Zoom calls every single day, like most of us are right now, jump on the video game, play a little video game. I've actually learned to actually love to play construction games on my, the iPhone. Jump on, do something that you're not used to. It might help you out. Another big thing that a lot of people may not realize might help them out is reading. Read a book, read the news, write. One of the biggest things I've learned during this COVID-19 is writing. Writing helps a lot of people out. Write your emotions, write your expressions, and that lets it out. And then when you start to write it out, you start to talk it out. When you start to talk it out, you let it out. When you let it out, you release a lot of stress from your body. we have to start practicing good mental hygiene. During this COVID-19, a lot of people are not practicing good mental hygiene. We have to remember that this is, once again, this is something traumatic to us. We're dealing with loss, and we're dealing with something that's not the norm. Let's make sure that we're getting ourselves out there and making sure we're taking care of ourselves first. Now, if we go to my last slide, social distancing tips. As I said earlier, make sure that you're staying 6 feet away from individuals. Also, making sure that you're not touching hand to hand, making sure that you're wearing the mask, making sure that you're wearing the mask properly. One of the biggest things I will tell you that we're seeing a lot out there, a lot of people are not wearing their mask properly. We have to make sure that we're wearing the mask covering our nose and our mouth. So you cannot wear your mask having your nose exposed, because any droplets, you can be exposed to COVID-19. You cannot wear your mask, I'm sorry, I'm imitating with my hand, but you cannot wear your mask up here and your mouth is still exposed. As you can see, I'm talking right here. You have to make sure that you're protecting yourself and making sure you're protecting the ones that you love. You go to work every day if you are going outside, and you're coming home every day. Make sure that you're taking care of the loved ones that you have at home, and make sure that you're not putting them at risk. I want to also leave this with you. I just actually recently just spoke to, I work with the Army, the guys that you see at Penn Station, around the city garden, the very serious sites around New York City. I just left them with this message just recently, letting them know as we enter the season of many holidays that we hold dear to us, we must remember that we are facing challenging times when it comes to our health, physically and mentally. This time of year, there may be one less family member or one less friend that is at our dinner table, but we have to stay strong for our loved ones because we have to continue moving on. It is okay to express yourself, how you feel, and talk with someone that you trust whenever you feel overwhelmed. It is okay to go for a walk, a run, a bicycle ride. Never hold back what you're feeling. Remember to continue to eat healthy and exercise regularly. As we continue to adjust to the public health guidelines, let us not forget to take the proper and necessary precautions to keep our families safe. Maintain your distance whenever out in public, wear your mask properly, and wash your hands regularly. Continue to spread positivity and healthy habits. It saves lives. Thank you so much for letting me talk about COVID-19. And if anyone have any questions, please do not hesitate to reach out to me on the Zoom chat, and I will let you know what's going on. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Derek. And much appreciated for those words of wisdom. We are extremely grateful of the work that you're doing at the front line. And as we transition now, as we talk about those who are the frontline workers, we cannot forget them. As we honor those who have passed, those who are survivors, we have to thank the frontline workers. And I know some of them are on the line right now. And just be prepared to say a few words, but I just want to read what we want to give a certificate to each of the first responders that we've acknowledged. And I'll just read the first one, and then I'll announce the names. And then I'll ask those who are on the line if you just can just say a few words. I know the commanding officer of the 105th Precinct is on the line. I know Leticia Williams, the bar manager of FDNY, is on the line, and anyone else who's on the line could say a few words. But it says, I'll just read it once. It says, the Rosedale Civic Association, Inc. would like to offer our heartfelt thanks and appreciation. You march into every single day while the general public are advised to stay home. It is easy to forget to say thank you, especially during this time of uncertainty. We want to take this time to thank you for your services to the community and beyond. In the face of adversity, you stand tall because you were trained to be the heroes of our society. We are eternally grateful for the work you do. And that's one went to the 105th Precinct. We also have O'Reilly Funeral Home, who, you know, had a difficult time as we tried to get our loved ones buried. That was very difficult. Long Island Jewish Medical Center, all the first responders at the hospitals that had to care for our loved ones. And we have Jamaica Hospital Medical Center, also right here in our communities. We Long Island Jewish of Valley Stream, also first responders. Springfield Engine 311, Ladder 158. That's the FDNY. And we also have the Brookville Engine 314. And also Brookville EMS Station number 54. All right. If there's anyone else, we said, so that's the names. If there's anyone on the time on the line now, can the commanding officer of the 105, if he can come on and just say a few words, and the bar manager of the FDNY and anyone else who's on the line that I had called their names.
Hello, good evening, everyone. How's everyone? You guys hear me?
Yes, great, thank you.
Hello, how are you? Yeah, thank you for putting this together. Obviously, COVID doesn't discriminate the communities, and every community in New York City and New York State and the country and the world get affected by this. But like Mr. Borough President said, we gotta stay strong and support each other and and look out for one another. Whether it's, you know, social distancing, wearing a mask, or helping each other out with the shopping. I know my parents are elderly, and when this happened, I wouldn't let them leave the house and deliver groceries to them and leave it on their stoop. So it's very important that we stick together. And stuff like this happens, and thank God 2020 is almost over. And I'm looking forward to 2021 because I think it's gonna be much better for all of us. Can be worse, right? The light is at the end of the tunnel. 2020 was definitely one of the years that we're gonna remember. We're gonna talk back and say, look at that. We had the riots, the COVID, the businesses affected by this. So I'm looking forward to 2021. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm sorry.
Good evening.
Good evening. Can you hear me well?
Yes, we can.
Okay, thank you so much. It is definitely a pleasure and an honor to be here. And on behalf of my commissioner, Daniel Nigro, and to the Queens Borough Command, Chief Schaff, and to all of our guys and battalion chiefs that services your district, to Engine 311, Ladder 158, and Engine 314, as well as EMS Station 54 on Merrick Boulevard. We thank you. It is an honor to serve the community in which we do every single day. We've all have experienced some loss. And like the borough president say, and everyone else on this line, we have to continue to band together. And I believe that with prayer and with God's help, that we're going to continue to get through this together. I myself as well am looking forward to 21. But let's not forget the lessons that we also learned in 2020 and take that as ammunition to push even further and to be more fervent in the things and in community service and in helping our neighbors. So again, I thank you so very much for having us, for inviting us. And each day we go out there, our guys go out there, and I can honestly say that they do what they love. They do what they love. And it is an honor to serve the Rosedale community, the Laurelton, the Springfield community, Community Board 13 and Community Board 12. And we pray that you will continue to stay safe, continue to please wear your masks, continue to please educate those who are not getting the information, to please continue to follow the fire department on fdnysmart.org/connect. We have a bunch of publications and showing how to protect yourself during these times, as well as with the holiday season around, where there's a lot of cooking on stove and, you know, with holiday lights around. This is our peak where there's a lot of fatal fires. So, you know, we're coming against that in prayer, but we still want everyone to use wisdom and what they're doing. So please continue to connect with us, and please call me at any given time of anything that is needed in your district, in your area, or even, you know, in your personal lives that you may need assistance from the fire department with. It is truly an honor and a pleasure. And I thank you again. Happy, safe holidays to everyone. And to please stay safe and be well.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Our commanding officer from the 105 precinct and also our FDNY bar manager. Thank you for those words of wisdom and encouragement. We truly appreciate it. And we know that you're at the front line. I also want to thank also a certificate for the O'Reilly Funeral Home. That's one of the first responders, as I mentioned. They do come out here. Is there anyone on the line from O'Reilly Funeral Home? Otherwise, we will continue. I'd like to now have some words, just reflections from some of those in our community. And after that, we'll have the reading of the names of those who have passed. Our pastor, Vincent Williams, who's the pastor of Parkway Baptist Church right here in Rosedale. He's our chaplain of the Rosedale Civic Association. Pastor, you're on. And we just wanted to say a few words. Then we'll have Pastor Sonia Chambers, senior pastor at Standard Bearer Ministries. And then we have our very own president and board chair of Rosedale Civic Association, Emlyn L. Taylor, in that order. Pastor Williams.
He might be muted. What's his number? Can somebody tell me, please?
845-661.
Okay, that's the one. Okay, Pastor Williams, can you unmute your phone? You have permission to unmute. Okay, may we ask Pastor Sonia to go while Pastor Williams tries to unmute his phone?
Okay, can everyone hear me?
Absolutely, yes. Pastor Sonia. Okay. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. And it's just such an honor to be a part of, be a Rosedale resident and be part of the Civic as well. And I just wanted to encourage us this evening, as we celebrate, as we remember, as we honor those who have gone through COVID-19, and also those who, who've passed on and those who are still even suffering the effects. Before going into full-time ministry, I was a registered nurse, and I was a hospice nurse for the last 7 years. So death is very evident in my life, I'll say that. And the grieving process that we all are going through is just at an immense proportion. But I just want to encourage you with one word: endure. Many have endured loss, pain, and also victory over and surviving COVID. But to endure may mean for some to continue in the same state. For others, it may mean to be firm under the suffering that we kind of go through or the misfortune. But one thing I want to say is that we cannot give up. We cannot give in. We have to stay connected and we have to stay loving and kind. I have two scriptures that I want to share with us before I close out, because I'm not long-winded at all. And I just want to encourage us with these two biblical scriptures. Romans 5:3-4 in the New Living Translation says, "We can rejoice too when we run into problems and trials, for we know that they help us develop endurance. And endurance develops strength of character, and character strengthens our confident hope of salvation." So Father, I even pray now in the name of Jesus that even during the most difficult times that we are going through, that we focus and are built by every issue and every circumstance and every trial that comes into our lives. And we thank God for strengthening us and encouraging us at this time. Even in this time when we feel separated and alone, we know you never leave us and you never forsake us. So even in this sensitive time during the holidays, we know your presence is always there. So I give him honor and I give him glory and I give Jesus all the praise for covering each and every one of us. And I bless you and your families during this season. And the last scripture I want to leave you with is 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 7. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. So I encourage you once again, let us just continue to love on each other. Let us not give up on each other. Let's call each other. Let's pray for each other as a community and stay connected in this time. Let us endure. So God bless you all. And we love you all at Standard Bearer Ministries in Rosedale, Queens. God bless.
God bless you.
Thank you so much, Pastor Amen. Sonia.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, we're going to have our Pastor Vincent Williams. You're
hearing me now?
Yes, we can. Yes.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. And I must give God thanks to be a part of this meeting that we are honoring the memory and the service of those who have involved themselves in this survival that we are in and faced with. We face it in so many different ways, personally and in support of others. We lend our service, we lend a hand, we give them support, we give gifts, and we donate, considering the fact that all of us can look at ourselves in some way and say, thank you, Lord, for this situation that I'm faced with. There is nothing that happens on this earth without the knowledge of Almighty God. And therefore, we may question the origin and the reason for the pandemic and the deaths and so on. But we who are here, even us at Rosedale, as we recognize and we give honor and praise to those who have served and are serving, that we give thanks to Almighty God for sparing us so that we too can lend a praise to him, because he's aware of all things. And also to ask that he comfort the hearts of those who have lost loved ones, and especially those of our frontline medical team that serve the sick and are giving themselves wholly to the work. We want you to remember them in your prayers. The doctors, the nurses, the ancillary staff, the support system, even the unfortunate situation where an EMS group of couple was robbed for no reason. So we have to acknowledge that there are some things that we cannot stop, but we can still give thanks to God. Although I have suffered, I've gotten a taste of the virus myself and was hospitalized in March. Thank God I'm here and can speak. I have preacher friends who were not as fortunate and have passed on. And there are many that we know from our congregation who have passed, two at the most, they went in the hospital and the nursing home quite okay, but never made it. So we say they may be unfortunate, but God knows best in all things, and we give him thanks, because nothing, as the scripture says, not even the sparrow that falls to the ground falls unnoticed to Almighty God. He knows all things. And he also says of us that he knows our needs before we even ask him. So let us be mindful of what we are going through as a nation, to pray for our nation, a divided country, which we can do without, the economic problems that we are faced with. And we thank God for those who are of a giving heart and have given of their resources and time to the less fortunate, to those who are on the brink of homelessness, those without a job. So we are mindful of everything that is going on around us, and we pray, Almighty God, that there will be a light, as one said before, at the end of this tunnel. So my prayer for each and every one of us is that God would keep us safe so that we will be able to do with our might what our hands find to do and love our neighbor as ourselves. God bless you all. And as you go into the Christmas season, though maybe we are confined at home, there are others that are not so fortunate. Let's remember them. And thanks again to the Civic Association for putting on this wonderful event where we can recognize and remember those who serve in our community. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pastor Vincent Williams, our chaplain, and Paso Parkway Baptist Church. We also have received a note that Pastor Carl DeFlorimonte would like to say a few words. He's Derek's father, and he's a pastor right here in Rosedale. You could speak, Pastor Carl. Tabernacle of Praise Church. Thank you.
Pastor Carl, you should be able to unmute yourself.
I'm sorry, this is Pastor Dorita DeFloriman. I'm just overwhelmed with joy knowing that
we're getting some feedback.
Yes, I'm getting. We're getting feedback. Okay. That we are connected to such a I'm just overwhelmed. Just forgive me. My mother passed with COVID on April 18th. And I had COVID also. And I'm still suffering from effects of COVID. And everything that I have heard today, I want to reiterate that it's very important to take COVID very seriously, because it is real. And it's very important for us to protect ourselves and also our loved ones and our friends. And I'm just grateful that God has put a team like this in Rosedale, whereby we could rally and support and comfort one another. And one of the things that really brought much happiness to my heart is knowing that you have put it out there that you're willing for folks to reach out to you, because there are so many that is hurting. I have met so many people that is hurting emotionally and also financially. And one of the things that I would like for us to do, I will speak to the Rosedale Civic Association, is that if we could come together, because Tabernacle of Praise would like to put some packages together for some folks that is really in need in Rosedale that really would not come out and say anything to others, but by mingling with them, I was able to learn of it, and also knowing that, you know, they're still suffering with the pain and loss of their loved one. At this point in time, I believe that mental health counseling, along also with grief counseling, is extremely important in this era. And I want you to know that I am available if there's anyone that is in need of grief counseling, because I am a certified thanatologist also, and also a mental health counselor. And I'm willing to work with others as I work through with my own grief and pain and suffering. Thank you all. You guys are always in my prayers. I am very lost for words tonight. I'm not one that is normally lost for words, but I'm just overwhelmed with happiness, knowing that I live in a community that is concerned for the lives of the civilians of Rosedale. Thank you very much, and may God continue to bless you as we continue to encourage each other and pray for one another. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Pastor. At this time, you're going to have our board president and board chair, Emlyn L. Taylor, who's so gracious and kind. We really look up to her and respect her. She lost her husband during COVID. So I really commend her, and actually she suffered herself. So we're all in this together, and we have to find someone to lean on. At this time, we'll have our president to speak.
First of all, good evening. Give praise to Lord, to our Lord, for whom, without whom, I'm not sure where I would be today. The Rosedale Civic Association would like to send our deepest condolences to the Florimonte family. We thank you, Pastor DeFloremonte, for coming on and sharing those words. They connected well with me, as Al mentioned. Just full of gratefulness, humbled, and just grateful for the support, the love. Our board is unmatched. I will put our board up against any other civic board in the world. They are the most caring, loving, supportive team of family members, not board members, that you will ever find. Tonight, we look to make sure that we celebrate those like myself, like Pastor Dorita, like Pastor Williams, and all the others who were spared by our Lord to still be here, because we have a further purpose, and we must not forget that we have a further purpose and honor that purpose. We also want to remember those like me and the many, many, many others, over 25,000 in New York, who have an angel in heaven. And then just continue to do everything we can to honor their memory. At this time, we have several board members who will be assisting in reading just a few of the names of those who the Lord has called home. When my husband had spent 23 days at North Shore University Hospital, and I was one of the blessed ones to get to go see him, when I left there, I knew that his time was short, and I gave it back to God. I told God that his will be done, and his will was to call home. my husband. It's not easy, but every day I look to others. I look to support. I look to do everything I can in order to focus on others rather than focusing on myself, because that's where the healing will begin. So we will first have, I apologize, before I introduce our first board member to read the names, if anybody on the line has lost a loved one or a family member or a friend, and you wanna put a message about them in the chat, this will be a very perfect time to add some fun memories or a kind word or a remembrance of them so others on the line can know and see what wonderful people they were. So we will first have Philip Ann Allison, who is our newly elected second vice president, youngest board member, and she's just amazing. We love and appreciate her. And then she will introduce the next board member. There'll be three board members helping to read the names, and then I will come back on and read the last set of names.
Good evening. Melvin Payne, Evelyn Harris Bourne, Al Haviland, Harold Andrew Book, Hazel Farnham, Louis Otley, Winston Patterson, Oswald Tucker. The next speaker is Evie Boyd.
Good evening. Eulalie Hunter, Salcedo Perez, Hayden Mobley, Antonio Solomon, Estelita Solomon, my cousin Ali Shaw, my friend and neighbor Marilyn Howard, and my cousin Marlena Wardrett. The next speaker is our president-elect, Marcia O'Brien.
Good evening. Oswald Tucker, Barris Patterson, my father, Ainsworth Nathaniel Hibbert, family friend, George Holness, Henrietta Voglison, grandmother to Derek De Floramonte, Reuben Johnson, my cousin, my friend Joel Cohen, my friend Alvin Wilson, or president and chairperson, Emlyn Taylor.
Apologies. Eulalie Hunter, Louis Otley, Hazel Farnham, Dorothy Palmer, Ruth Heavlaw, father of a dear, dear friend, college friend, longtime friend, Raymond E. Hernandez, cousin Lynn Varela, and my dear husband, Jules Taylor Jr. Love you and miss you. In loving memory, those we love don't go away. They walk beside us every day, unseen, unheard, but always near. Still loved, still missed, and very dear.
Thank you so much, our president. And one of the things we've learned about this virus, it doesn't matter who you are, it will show up. Whether you're rich, whether you're poor, whether you're young, whether you're old, And we just have to keep our trust in God and in Jesus. At this time, we'll have our closing remarks by Marcia O'Brien, who's our president-elect of the Rosedale Civic Association. And then we'll have our benediction by Dr. Ainsworth Joseph, who's a senior pastor of the Seventh-day Adventist Village Fellowship Worship Center. Thank you.
Good evening again, everyone. Everyone has experienced some form of hardship during this pandemic, whether it's from the loss of a loved one like myself, emotional or financial hardship. We've come to realize that these are trying times. These are times when our community need each other. We need each other the most. To our religious leaders, because sometimes we forget to mention that, to our religious leaders, our first responders, our frontline and essential workers, our families, friends, and neighbors, on behalf of the Rosedale Civic Association, thank you for all that you continue to do to stay safe through these trying times. I love you all. Thank you.
Shall we look to the Lord at this time? Almighty God, we look to you this evening, for we have no other help but you. You are our shelter from the stormy blast, and you are our eternal home. We pause this evening to fondly remember and lovingly remember the lives and the legacies of all who have succumbed to the COVID-19 coronavirus. We will never shake a finger of accusation in your face, for you are not the author of sickness, of pain, and death. But every good gift and every perfect gift come down from the Father of light, with whom there is no variation, neither shadow of turning. So God, reach down from heaven and just be to each one who was touched by losing loved ones or touched with this illness. Reach down and touch them in the area and in a method that they would need you to touch them and strengthen them at this difficult time. We reckon that in the hearts of many surviving family members, there's pain. There is an aching void. There is an empty chair around dinner tables. Heal the hurts. Fill the aching void. Occupy that empty chair around the dinner tables and provide a comfort and the strength and the hope that loved ones would need to carry on this journey of life. We thank you for the Rosedale Civic Association leadership who provided and organized this healing service this evening. Continue, God, to bless them, bless their initiatives that they will put forth to improve the quality of life for residents of our communities. We would remember our first responders and our healthcare workers for their unflinching commitment to care for the sick, to care for even the dying. May you provide the strength, the grace that they need as they administer healing touch to those who are sick and to those who need it. Provide wisdom to our local and state and federal leadership as they navigate the way forward through this pandemic. Oh God, stretch forth your hand. You have said in your word, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray, would seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, you have said, you will hear from heaven and you will forgive their sins and you will heal their land. America needs healing. The world needs healing. Stretch forth your hand and stay this pandemic that's hovering over our nation and the world. And then, God, we say, even so, come quickly and usher in your kingdom of glory, where there will be no more COVID-19, no more sickness, no more pain, no more crying, no more death. And we all shall be with you in your kingdom as we live to serve you here on this earth. We shall be united, reunited with loved ones who loved you and who died in you, who departed this life through COVID and other means. We will be together again because Jesus has conquered death and hell and the grave. So come, Lord, quickly. And when the saints go marching home, may we all be in that number. We praise you. We thank you. We adore you. We love you. In the name of the Father and of the Son and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. And amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much, Dr. Joseph, for that benediction and those kind words of healing on behalf of the Rosedale Civic Association. Alfred Osmer, I really was touched being your master ceremonies. We all, those who have gone, will never be forgotten. The Rosedale Civic will never forget you. Those who need healing, we will never forget you. And we will look at programs of how we can continue to keep this alive, because we need to be there for each other and be free for each brother's keeper, and be there to ask God to lead us in the right direction as we go forward to help, because this has impacted the entire world. So we need God right at the forefront of it all. Thank you all. May God continue to bless you, and may heaven shine upon you and be grateful unto you. God bless you.
We are going to actually, if Assemblywoman Alicia Hyndman is still on and wants to address us shortly, just a few words. We saw your post, but if you would like to say anything, we would love to have you.
Thank you, Emlyn, and I've just been doing several Zooms and still listening in the background. And I just want to thank everyone for their courage. And as I said in the chat, no one prepares you how to deal with so much during this time. And your leadership of this organization has been tremendous, Emlyn. And I want to thank you for that. And to all of your members, there are too many names to mention in and around the Southeast Queens neighborhoods. And the fact that you're doing this on a Saturday night tells me that you have not forgotten those who have gone on, and you've been able to recognize the first responders. And I just wanted to say very quickly to Derek, when he was going through his grandmother had been diagnosed, his mother was diagnosed, and he was still testing correction officers from around the city at the facility at Jones Beach. And that just told me, no matter what he was going through, he still put people before himself. And that just exemplifies what Rosedale Queens is, that all of you have recognized those who needed help. Whether it's good times or bad times, we all come together and make everyone accountable and make everyone stand up. And you all have been able to do that. And shouldering so much at a time like this has been tremendous. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you for your leadership. Thank you for still doing Zooms at this time. Thank you for staying engaged and making sure that you always lift this community up. And thank you. Have a good night, everyone. And continue.
Emily, could I say one thing?
Of course. I'm sorry. Thank you so much, Assemblywoman Woman Hyman. I know that you're working still. So thank you for all that you do. And of course, Dr. Joseph.
Yeah, we actually have a member of my church who is on. David Farnham, his wife succumbed, having been touched with the virus. He got the virus and survived, and today he celebrated 80 years.
Oh, wow. Happy and birthday.
I believe he's on the platform here tonight.
Happy birthday. We are so grateful that you are on. We're so grateful that God has seen fit to allow you to be with us and sending you the happiest of 80th birthdays, even though you are missing your lovely bride at this time. We have two songs to send us off, but that ends our program. I want to thank our amazing board member, Al Osborne, for being the MC. And I want to thank all the board members. There are many of us who didn't participate, so you didn't get to see their faces this evening, but it was truly a team effort. We pray that this event, this ceremony, was exactly what you had hoped it would be, and that it honored the memories and remembers the families and celebrates those of us who are still here. I see our president-elect has her hand raised, and then we will play our two songs and we will let everybody go. We thank you for coming on a Saturday evening to be with us. Continue to be safe, continue to be well, continue to be there for each other. I believe it was our borough president and maybe a few others who said it, the best way for us to heal and do and just be the best of ourselves is to be the best for each other. President-elect Marcia O'Brien, the floor is yours.
Yes, although we are faced with this pandemic, we have to remember that there are our children that are still in need. So we're continuing with our annual Christmas with Santa. We're in our 11th year. We will meet in front of the Rosedale Library Saturday the 19th at 1 p.m. We'll be giving out some wrap toys for the younger children and gift cards. Folks in the community donated. I cannot list the amount of people that donated. So it's a giving season and we're all here to help embrace each other. I look forward to everyone coming out and support what we are doing for our families in Rosedale. See you guys at 1 p.m. on Saturday. Thank you so much.
All right, as we close out, you can continue to put messages of hope, of if you have events coming up you'd like folks to come and participate in, you can put those in the chat and you can start to log off, but we are gonna be playing two more songs. If you want to hang out, that's great too.
We're living in a time where everybody is struggling for their lives. The stressed, the depressed. With the power invested in me, I can't even speak life. My brothers and sisters all around the world. You're gonna live, oh my brother, my sister, I speak alive. You are the head and not the tail. I speak alive. Don't give up the fight for your life. You shall live and not die. Let's not lose another person to a senseless death. Substance abuse, gang violence, suicide because of low self-esteem. The power of life and death is in the tongue. Speak life over yourself and those you love.
Well, I still feel you here with me. You're more just keeps on going. It has no way of knowing that you're wrong.
Your presence we miss, your memory we treasure, loving you always, forgetting you never. Thank you and good evening.